Welcome to you all in my today's lecture. Today I am going to discuss the sedimation. In my last lecture, I was discussed about the mitosis type of sedimation from embryology. Today I am going to discuss the meiosis sedimation. First, the definition of meiosis. It is a type of sedimation that yields four haploid cell or gamete with its 23 chromosome from a diploid parent cell. It is observed only during maturation of sex cell. We know mitosis occurs in immature germ cell and somatic cell, and meiosis occurs maturation of sex cell. Events of meiosis are meiosis 1 and meiosis 2. Meiosis 1, it is a reduction division because each daughter cell receives half the number of chromosomes. The phases of meiosis are consist of, first one is prophase 1. It is a prolonged process and consists of the following stages. First stage is the leptotic. The individual chromosome composed of two chromatids joined at the centromere are visible as long thin thread. This is the leptotic stage. The chromosomes are visible and composed of two chromatids joined at the centromere. They appear as a long thin thread. Then zygote. Homologous chromosomes are arranged in pair. This process is called synapsis. There is pairing of the homologous chromosome. One member of pair is maternal and other member is paternal in origin. So zygote, there is a pairing of the homologous chromosome. The figure shows the pairing of the chromosome. There is pair of chromosome before DNA replication. There is pairing of the chromosome after DNA replication. This is the centromere and this is the chromatid. These are called two sister chromatids. Third stage is the bacchidine. Each chromosome split longitudinally into two chromatids, except at the centromere, four chromatids are formed. This phenomenon is known as tetrad formation. Here, crossing over occurs. Two central chromatids, non-sister chromatids of tetrad, cross each other at one or more points, forming the chiasma. Diploid stage, there is chiasma formation. And in bacchidine stage, there is crossing of the homologous chromosome. At the point of crossing, chromatid break with the help of enzyme endonuclease. Then unite with a segment of non-sister chromatid of homologous chromosome, catalyzed by another enzyme ligase. At first, in diploid stage, there is crossing of homologous chromosome form the chiasma, and at the point of crossing, the chromosome are breakdown with the help of enzyme endonuclease. Then they are reunite with a segment of non-sister chromatid of homologous chromosome by the another enzyme ligase. This phenomenon is known as crossing over. There is exchange of genetic material occur between homologous chromosomes. What happened during crossing over? There is exchange of genetic material occur between homologous chromosomes. The last stage of prophase 1 is diagenesis. The homologous centromeres pull apart. The chromosomes are separated. Nuclear membrane and nucleolus disappear, like mitosis of prophase of mitosis division. Here, at the end of prophase, nuclear membrane and nucleolus disappear. The picture shows the different stages of prophase 1. At first, leptotic stage, here chromosomes are shortened, thickened, and condensed. They appear as a long thin thread and become visible. Then zygote, the homologous chromosome begin to pair. This pairing phenomenon is called synapsis. Then bacchidine, the homologous chromosome cross over In diplodine stage, there is chiasma formation and after crossing over, the breakdown of the homologous chromosome at the point of crossing, then they reunite with the segment of non-sister chromatid of the chromosome. Breakdown occurs by the help of enzyme endonuclease and it reunites by the enzyme ligase. Last stage is the diagenesis. The chromosomes are pulling apart. At the end of prophase, here nuclear membrane and nucleus are disappear. Then metaphase 1. The homologous pair of chromosomes with their chromatid are arranged around the equator of achromatic spindle. These are mitotic spindle. Homologous chromosomes are arranged around the equator of the spindle. Then anaphase 1. The homologous chromosomes separate and migrate towards the pole of the spindle. These homologous chromosomes are separate and migrate towards the pole of the spindle. Telophase 1. The chromosome reaches the opposite pole. Nucleoli and nuclear membrane are reformed. Cytoplasm divides and gives rise to two daughter cells. These are haploid number of double structure chromosomes. After mitosis, there are two daughter cells are formed. These are haploid number which contain 23 chromosomes and number chromosome, and these are double structure chromosome. Is it clear? Can anyone respond?
Yes, ma'am.
From 9 batch, from 40.
Yes.
Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Tell me the definition. Any second year student?
Yes, ma'am.
Can I ask, please?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Who are speaking to, please? Second, please no number. Can anyone tell me the definition of meiosis?
It is a type of cell division that yields four haploid cells or gametes from a diploid parent cell.
Sir, from first year or second year?
Ma'am, first year.
First year. Tell me your roll number.
Ma'am, 9012. Money 12.
1, 2, 12. Okay. Events of meiosis are meiosis 1 and meiosis 2. Meiosis 1 is called reduction division and it has
prophase
1, anaphase 1, and telophase 1. Four phases. Have five phases: leptotin, zygotin,
pachytin, diakinesis,
and diakinesis. What happens in leptotin stage?
Ma'am, ekshathe hoy chromosome gula, mane
chromosome begin to condense, shorten, and visible.
Yes, ma'am.
Then what happens during zygotin stage? This is the
homologous.
What happened here?
Ma'am, jora srishti hoy.
Homologous chromosome. Synapses occur here. This process is called synapses.
Yeah. Crossing over hoy. मैम क्रॉसिंग ओवर काइस्मा सृष्टि है क्रॉसिंग ओवर है
देन डिक्लोडिन व्हाट हैपेंड
क्रॉसिंग मैम एक्सचेंज
व्हाट डू मीन बाय क्रॉसिंग ओवर
मैम अंशर विनिमय होमोलोगस क्रोमोसोम के मध्य जी मैम
देयर आर एक्सचेंज ऑफ डीएनए
डीएनए जी मैम
देन एनाफेज क्रोमोसोम
आर पुलिंग अपार्ट प्रांत दिखे जाए प्रांत कूल माने मेरु
सिस्टर क्रोमेट सेपरेट फ्रॉम ईच अदर
एनाफेज 1 मैम एनाफेज 1
मैम सिस्टर क्रोमेट इज सेपरेट फ्रॉम ईच अदर
ओ है
व्हाट डू यू रोल नंबर
मैम 090
9
फ्रॉम 9th
यस मैम
एनी सेकंड ईयर स्टूडेंट प्लीज रिस्पोंड व्हाट हैपेंड ड्यूरिंग एनाफेज स्टेज
एनाफेज
द क्रोमोसोम आर पुलिंग अपार्ट टुवर्ड्स द स्पिंडल ड्यूरिंग टेलोफेज देयर आर टू हैप्लॉइड of their nuclear membrane and nucleus are reformed. This chromosome contains 23 number of chromosome. These are double structure. Then they go to the meiotic division. That four cell are formed. All are contain 23 number of chromosome, but they are single structure. Is it clear, meiosis?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Difference between mitosis and meiosis. Mitosis occur in somatic cell and immature germ cell. Meiosis observed only during maturation of sex cell. We know two daughter cell are produced during the mitosis and four daughter cell are produced during meiosis cell division. In mitosis, each daughter cell contain diploid number of chromosome. In meiosis, each daughter cell contains haploid number of chromosome. Mitosis is one complete phase, meiosis two different phases. There is meiosis one and meiosis two. In mitosis, no chiasma and crossing over occur. In meiosis, no chiasma and crossing over occur during meiosis. This is important point for your viva exam. Chiasma and crossing over occur where? During meiosis. No pairing. Homologous chromosome in mitosis, but in meiosis there is pairing of homologous chromosome. This is the difference between mitosis and meiosis. It is also important question for your written exam. The figure shows the difference between mitosis and meiosis. There is two daughter cell are formed, diploid number, and there is four daughter cell after meiosis. There is four daughter cell are formed, which are haploid in number. All contain the 23 chromosome. Most of the hazard of the chromosomal number take place at anaphase. Non-disjunction, anaphase lag, non-disjunction after splitting of centromere. We knew the anaphase stage, there is splitting of the chromosome. And they migrate to the opposite pole of spindle. But in non-disjunction, after splitting of the centromere, one or more chromosome fail to migrate properly due to abnormal function of spindle. This phenomenon is known as non-disjunction. What is non-disjunction? After splitting of the centromere, one or more chromosome fail to migrate properly due to abnormal function of spindle apparatus. This phenomenon is known as the non-disjunction. This is normal meiotic cell division. The chromosome are equally migrate. Here, the chromosome fails to migrate. This is the non-disjunction of meiotic cell division. As a result, both members of particular pair go to one daughter cell. Both members of particular pair go to one daughter cell, which receive extra chromosome. 24 trisomy. The other daughter cell deficient death. Here is 22. Normally there are 23 chromosomes in both daughter cells. But in northeast junction, the member of particular pair go to one daughter cell which receive the extra chromosome. It contains 24 chromosomes. This condition is called trisomy. And other daughter cell deficient of that chromosome, here 22, one is missing. The 22 instead of normal 23 chromosome. This condition is called the monosomy. When extra chromosome is added, there is 24 chromosome. This condition is called the trisomy. And when one chromosome is missing, there is 22 chromosome. This condition is called the monosomy. When at fertilization, a gamete having 23 chromosome, the result is an individual with either 47 chromosome. When during gamete having 23 chromosome, of these 24 chromosome, there is 47 number the trisomy. Here, extra chromosome present.
Ma'am, kotha shona jacche na.
Ma'am, ager gulo shona jay na etokkhon.
Ager gulo kotha theke bolo to. Non disjunction.
Ma'am, er age slide.
Ma'am, eta hocche.
Ma'am, ekhon theke.
In case of non-disjunction, both member of particular pair go to one daughter cell which receive the extra chromosome. Non-disjunction means the chromosome fails to migrate properly due to abnormal function of the mitotic spindle. In non-disjunction, both members of the particular pair go to the one daughter cell and receive the extra chromosome. There is 24 instead of 23. This condition is called the trisomy. And other daughter cell is deficient that there is 22 instead of 23. This condition is called the monosomy. When at fertilization, a gamete having 23 chromosome fuses of that 24 chromosome is 47. Any problem?
আমি একটা প্রশ্ন ছিল আমার।
Any problem? Tell me.
জি ম্যাম, ম্যাম মাদার সেল গুলো তো প্রত্যেকটা থেকে আলাদা থাকে, তাহলে এটা তো 24টা হলে এটাতে 22টা হচ্ছে, এটাতে শুধু কোনো কানেকশন আছে, কানেকশন নেই তো।
এখানে ক্রোমোজোম আর মাইগ্রেট in one daughter cell, both pair of chromosome migrate in one daughter cell. যদি একটাতে চলে যায় তাহলে 24 এর বদল 23 এর বদল এখানে এক্সট্রা ক্রোমোজোম থাকবে, এখানে চলে এসেছে কিন্তু এখানে ওই ক্রোমোজোমটা মিসিং, সো দেয়ার ইজ 22 ক্রোমোজোম ইনস্টেড 23.
जी मैम,
इज इट क्लियर? क्लियर?
यस मैम।
ओके थैंक यू। व्हेन ए फर्वेंट एंड फर्टिलाइजेशन ए गैमेट हैविंग 23 क्रोमोसोम फ्यूजेस विद गैमेट हैविंग 24 क्रोमोसोम, हियर द क्रोमोसोम नंबर ऑफ आर 47 एक्स्ट्रा क्रोमोसोम। যখন কোন 23 ক্রোমোসোম অলা গ্যামেট এই 24 ক্রোমোসোম কে ফার্টিলাইজ করবে তখন টোটাল নাম্বার মনোজমি। Is it clear?
जी मैम
यस मैम
कैन यू व्हाट इज मोनोजूमी व्हाट इज ट्राइजूमी
मैम मोनोजूमी होते मोनोजूमी होते हैं
मैम क्रोमोसोम नंबर 22 इंस्टेड ऑफ 23
मैम कथा शुना जा रहा
occur during mitosis, mitotic non-disjunction, in an embryonic cell during the earlier cell division, such condition produces mosaicism. Normally, non-disjunction occurred in mitosis. When it occurred in mitotic cell division, this is the mosaicism. Some cell having an abnormal chromosome number and other being normal. Anaphase lag. What is anaphase lag? Sometimes after splitting the centromere, one member of newly formed chromosome separate as usual forming normal chromosome complement in one daughter cell, whereas the other member fail to reach the opposite pole of spindle, resulting deficiency of that chromosome in other daughter cell. This is known as the anaphase lag. Isochromosome sometimes centromere split transversely instead of longitudinal division. We know the centromere split longitudinally. Sometimes centromere split transversely instead of longitudinal division. This results in the formation of two daughter chromosome of unequal length. This condition is known as the isochromosome. The normal human somatic cell contain 46 chromosome and normal gametes, sperm and ovum contain 23. Normal somatic cell are diploid or 2m. Normal gamete are haploid or n. Aneuploidy. Aneuploidy means it is a condition when extra chromosome is present, trisomy, or when one is missing monosomy. Both monosomy and trisomy together are called the aneuploidy. Polyploidy. Sometimes after the formation of two nuclear membrane enveloping the normal number of chromosome, the cytoplasm fails to divide and nuclear membrane fuses to form a common envelope with which enter both number of normal chromosome. This condition is called the polyploidy. Sometimes after formation of two nuclear membrane enveloping the normal chromosome, the cytoplasm fails to divide and the nuclear membrane fuses to form a common envelope which enter the double number of normal chromosome. This condition is called the polyploidy. It is usually found in liver cell mucosa of the urinary bladder. Cell cycle. What is cell cycle? The cyclic alternation between mitosis and interphase is known as cell cycle. Interphase, it is the period between mitosis. The cell cycle has four distinct phases: mitosis and interphase. Interphase contains gap 1, G1 phase. The time gap between mitosis and DNA replication is the gap 1 phase. There is active synthesis of RNA and protein. In gap 1 phase, there is active synthesis of RNA and protein. S phase, the period of DNA synthesis. G2 or gap 2, the gap between DNA replication and the next mitosis. This is the G2 phase. So cell cycle contains mitosis and interphase. Interphase has three phases, G1, S and G2. G1 is the time gap between mitosis and DNA replication. Here, synthesis of RNA and protein. Then S phase, there is DNA synthesis. G2 phase, gap between DNA replication and next mitosis. The figure shows the cell cycle. The time required for G1 phase is 25 hours, S phase 8 hours, G2 phase 2 to 3 hours. After mitosis, both new cells repeat this cycle. In repeatedly dividing cell, G1 is a period which cells accumulate the enzyme and nucleotide required for DNA replication. S is the period devoted primarily to DNA replication. G2 is usually short period of preparation for mitosis. F include all phases of mitosis itself. In rapidly growing human tissue, the cell cycle varies 24 to 36 hours. Normally, G1 phase requires the 25 hours. Next is the gametogenesis. The definition of gametogenesis is conversion of germ cell into male and female gamete, or in preparation for fertilization, both male and female germ cell undergo a number of chromosomal and morphological changes. This process is known as gametogenesis. Gametogenesis, there are two processes, spermatogenesis in male and oogenesis in female. We know the spermatogenesis occurred in seminiferous tubule of testes and oogenesis occurred in the ovary. Now, oogenesis. Oogenesis is the process of maturation of primordial female germ cells from primary oocyte to mature ovum. What is oogenesis? The process of maturation of primordial germ cells from primary oocyte to mature ovum. Time of beginning oogenesis, it occurs during intrauterine life, and we know spermatogenesis occurs when spermatogenesis occurs. Can anyone respond when spermatogenesis occurs?
At the age of puberty.
At the puberty, and oogenesis begins in the intrauterine life.
Intrauterine life.
Oogenesis. The process of maturation of primordial female germ cell from primary oocyte to mature ovum. This process is known as the oogenesis, and it begins in the intrauterine life. The steps of oogenesis are primordial germ cell differentiate into oogonia in the ovary. And first, primordial germ cell differentiate into oogonia in the ovary. The majority of oogonia continue divide by mitosis and form the primary oocyte. First is the primordial germ cell, then it differentiates into the oogonia, then oogonia differentiates into by mitosis into primary oocyte. Its primary oocyte surrounded by a layer of flattened epithelial cell. This known as the follicular cell. The primary oocyte and the flattened follicular cell together called the primordial follicle. This is called the primordial follicle. Then primary oocyte enter into prophase of first meiotic division. Primordial germ cell, then oogonia, then primary oocyte. Primary oocyte enter into prophase of first meiotic division. The primary oocyte complete the prophase of first meiotic division at birth and enter into a prolonged wasting stage, diploidine stage. Primary oocyte remain arrested in prophase and do not finish their first meiotic division before puberty is reached. The first meiotic division complete just before to the ovulation. This arrested state is produced by oocyte maturation inhibitor. There is a factor, this is called OMI factor, oocyte maturation inhibitor, secreted by the follicular cell, which arrested the primary oocyte in prophase of diploidine stage. When first meiotic division is completed,
at the birth, man.
Speak loudly. When first meiotic division is completed,
at the age of birth, man.
Just before the action. It is arrested up to the puberty. In puberty, there is ovulation occurred and first meiotic division completed just before the ovulation. There is inhibitor factor which inhibit the first meiotic division up to the puberty. There is also maturation inhibitor which is secreted by the follicular cell. Now, latent cell from pubertal. A single layer of pubertal cell. This is the primary oocyte. This is the glycoprotein layer. So primordial germ cell here is the platelet follicular cell. Now this platelet cell becomes cubital and arranged in a single layer. This is called primary follicle. So follicular differentiation begin with the transition of the site. Primordial follicle, then primary follicle. Primary follicle, in case of primordial follicle, here primary oocyte surrounded by a Prinzmetta's epithelial cell. Together this primary oocyte and the primordial follicle, then it differentiate into the primary follicle. Primary follicle, the flattened epithelial cell become cubital, and this primary oocyte and this cubital cell are called the primary follicle. Here single layer of the cell follicular cell, it is called unilaminar primary follicle. This unilaminar cell differentiate into stratified, it is called multilayer primary follicle. The single layer differentiate into multilayer. Here more than one layer, it is called stratified. This is the multilaminar primary follicle. At first primordial follicle, then primary follicle. It is single layer unilaminar primary follicle, and it is multilayer, it is multilayer primary follicle. And oocyte arrested up to the puberty. Primary oocyte enlarges and follicular cell become pubertal and multiply into several layers of cells. Glycoprotein accumulate between the inner layer of the follicular cell and the oocyte. These substances fit and complete sided membrane known as dunna pellucida. This is called dunna pellucida. It is a glycoprotein layer. As the follicle enlarges, the numerous fluid-filled spaces appear. As the follicle enlarges, the numerous fluid-filled spaces appear in between the follicular cell. This space coalesces to form the single cavity known as the antrum folliculi. When primary oocyte enlarges, the follicle also enlarges, and there is a fluid-filled spaces appear in between the follicular cell. This is called antrum folliculi, and there is a fluid present in the antrum. This is called Likert folliculi. The cavity is called the antrum, and fluid is called the Likert folliculi. As a result, the follicular cell separate into an outer layer named as the stratum granulosum. This is called stratum granulosum. This is the connective tissue layer, stratum granulosum or membrana granulosa. This is the membrana granulosa. As a result, the follicular cell separate into an outer layer named as the stratum granulosum and inner layer known as the cumulus ovaricus. The cumulus around the primary oocyte. Outside the stratum granulosum of the follicle, the stroma cells of the ovary, these are the connective tissue. Stroma cell of ovary organized to form a sheath known as theca folliculi. These two layer together called the theca folliculi. This theca folliculi differentiate into two layer. Outer cellular layer known as the theca externa and inner vascular layer known as the theca interna. So as the follicle enlarge, the cells are differentiate into outer membrana granulosa and inner, which surround the primary oocyte. This is called the cumulus ovarius. The stromal cells of the ovary, this together is called the theca folliculi, which differentiate into outer cellular layer, the theca externa, and inner vascular layer, the theca interna. This structure is called the mature Graafian follicle. This is important question for your region, also your mega exam. Go and label the Graafian follicle and what are the structure present in the Graafian follicle. The theca interna and outer fibrous layer, the theca externa. Basement membrane intervene between the cells of the theca interna and stratum granulosum. At this stage, the primary oocyte from the diploid stage complete the first mutic division, which was started during prenatal life. Is it clear? Oogenesis. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
From second year student, can anyone please respond? Any second year student present here?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yummy. Why do you please tell your name and roll number?
Ma'am, Shaun Nundi,
28. 28. Is there any another student from here?
Ma'am, 43.
43. Okay. 43, tell me the definition of the oogenesis. What is oogenesis? Second year student, what is oogenesis?
Process of maturation of primordial female germ cells from primary oocyte to mature ovum.
To mature ovum. What are the steps of when oogenesis begin?
Primordial cell.
When oogenesis begin?
Primordial germ cell.
No, it is begin in intrauterine life.
Intrauterine life.
Oogenesis occurred during the puberty. At puberty.
Puberty.
What are the steps of oogenesis?
First primordial follicle.
Then?
Then primary follicle.
When do you call primordial follicle? Which structure you call the primordial follicle? Which structure you call the primordial follicle? When primary oocyte surrounded by a flattened follicular cell or sponge epithelial cell, this structure is called the primordial follicle. Then it differentiates to primary follicle. At this stage, primary primordial germ cell differentiated to oogonia, then it differentiates into the primary oocyte by mitosis. As well as follicular differentiation begin the primordial follicle to differentiate into the primary follicle. Primary follicle, this flattened epithelial cell become cuboidal. This is the primary follicle. This flattened epithelial cell become cuboidal. This is the single layer, so it is called unilaminar primary follicle. Here, single layer differentiate into multi-layer, multi-layer follicular cell. This structure is called the multilaminar primary follicle. And this is the zona pellucida. It is the glycoprotein layer which separates the primary oocyte from the follicular cell. So primordial follicle differentiates into the primary follicle. And what happens in the oocyte, primary oocyte during this stage?
Primary oocyte.
Primary oocyte enter into the prophase of first meiotic division. In this, the primary oocyte complete the prophase of first meiotic division at birth and enter into a prolonged resting stage, diploid stage of meiotic division. Primary oocyte remain arrested in prophase. Do not finish their first meiotic division before puberty is reached. And this arrested condition is influenced by the oocyte maturation inhibitor factor, which is secreted by this follicular cell. This follicular cell secreted the oocyte maturation inhibitor factor. So oocyte is, primary oocyte is arrested in diploid of first meiotic division. Is it clear? Is it clear? 43, 28. All other students?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then secondary follicle. When we call the secondary follicle? What happens?
Primary.
This primary oocyte enlarges in size and follicular cell becomes adult and multiply into several layers. Primary oocyte enlarges and follicular cell become pivotal and multiply into several layers of cells. Glycogen accumulated between the inner layer of the follicular cell and the oocyte. This substance fuses and forms the complete cytoid membrane. This is called zona pellucida, which separates from the primary oocyte to the follicular cell. As the follicle enlarges, the numerous fluid filled spaces appear in between the follicular cell. This condition is called the secondary follicle. When this happens, this condition is called the secondary follicle. This cavity fills to form a single cavity. This is called antrum, and this cavity filled with the fluid. This is called Dicar folliculi. Is it clear? Stage? Clear up to this stage?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. Then, as a result of the follicular cell separate into an outer layer named as the stratum granulosum. When cavity enlarges, the follicle cell are separate, form a outer layer known as the membrana granulosa or stratum granulosum, and form an inner layer which surround the oocyte. This is called cumulus ocurrens. Here, primary oocyte entered the first meiotic division and form the secondary oocyte. So there is a secondary oocyte, and surround the secondary oocyte, these cells are called cumulus ocurrens. Outside the stratum granulosum, the stromal cells of the ovary organize to form a sheath. These are the connective tissue sheath. This is called theca folliculi. This theca folliculi differentiate into an outer cellular layer known as the theca externa and inner vascular layer known as the theca interna. This connective tissue or stromal cell separate from the membrana granulosa, that is membrane. This condition is called the Graafian follicle, mature Graafian follicle. What are the structure present in the Graafian follicle?
Theca externa, theca interna, secondary set, first polar body, formulas, ocurrens.
Ma'am, suna jaye na.
Can you hear?
Yes, ma'am, it is clear now.
So this is the Graafian follicle. At this stage, the primary oocyte from diplodine stage complete the first meiotic division. What is the definition of ovulation? When Graafian follicle is formed at the puberty, the rupture of Graafian follicle with liberation of secondary oocyte. This condition is called the ovulation. Ovulation, the secondary oocyte complete the primary oocyte complete the first meiotic division, which was starting during the prenatal life. After the crossing over, the chromosomes separate and one member passes centrally while the other member passes up. Separate from the oocyte to form the first. The result of this division is C23 chromosome haploid number. there is 22 autosome and one is the sex chromosome. Division is and although the nuclear division is equal, the cytoplasm is one cell is large, receive abundant large, small carrying can be cytoplasm. The polar body is hidden in space between the zona pellucida and the cell membrane. This is the first polar body. One cell contain the abundant cytoplasm, which is the secondary oocyte. And other cell, there is lack of cytoplasm. This is the first polar body. It lies between the oocyte cell membrane and the prehydrilline space. This is the first polar body. Then the secondary oocyte entered the meiosis II but arrest in the metaphase approximately 3 hours before ovulation. Before 3 hours before ovulation, the secondary oocyte then entered the meiosis II. Meiosis II is completed only if the oocyte is fertilized. Well, if when first meiotic division is completed, when first meiotic division is completed, just before the ovulation at the puberty. In puberty, there is menstruation occur at the middle of the menstruation. The 20-day cycle, 14th day, there is ovulation occur. Just before the ovulation, the oocyte completed its first meiotic division. The ovulation is the when Ruffian follicle is developed. This in during ovulation. This is discharge from the ovary. This condition is the ovulation. Just before to the ovulation, the primary oocyte completed its first meiotic division. Then this second, then it differentiates into the secondary oocyte. This secondary oocyte then entered the meiosis II. Here, when Ruffian follicle is formed, this is the mature follicle. When Ruffian follicle is formed, here second, this Ruffian follicle at the 28-day cycle. This condition is called the ovulation. When ovulation occurred, the first meiotic division is completed. Then the secondary oocyte entered the second meiotic division and formed the mature ova. During first meiotic division, there is one polar body is formed, and during second meiotic division, there is another two polar bodies formed. The polar body is the cell which contain less amount of the cytoplasm. Two cells are formed which contain abundant cytoplasm. This is the mature ova, and another cell contain the less amount of the cytoplasm. This is called the second polar body. The outer cell of the cumulus ovaricals disintegrate and disappear, and those adjacent to the zona pellucida are arranged readily as the corona radiata. These cells are called the corona radiata. This arranged radially and called the corona radiata. This is the secondary oocyte and this is the first polar body during first meiotic division. Here, when second meiotic division occurred, the secondary oocyte differentiated into mature ovum and another polar body. The first polar body undergo another polar body occurred, and first polar body under second meiotic division entered the second meiotic division, and another two polar body are formed. The ovum contain abundant amount of cytoplasm, and polar body there is less amount of cytoplasm. So this is called the polar body. I repeat this: at first primordial germ cell, then it differentiate into oognia, then it differentiate into primary oocyte by mitosis. Primary oocyte entered the first meiotic division. It completed from the secondary oocyte. Then secondary oocyte entered the second meiotic division. A mature ovum is formed, and first polar body, a second polar body is the form. First polar body undergo second meiotic division. Here two polar body are formed. There are three polar body in meiotic cell division. And follicular changes, at first it is primordial follicle then changes into the primary follicle. This is the primary follicle. Then it differentiates into the secondary follicle. Then it differentiates into mature Graafian follicle. So the oogenesis. It is very important level with liberation of secondary oocyte from the surface of the ovary is called ovulation. Ovulation takes place at the middle of the menstrual cycle about 14 days prior to the onset of next menstrual bleeding. On average, each menstrual cycle is 28 days duration. Corpus luteum, after ovulation, the wall of follicle collapse. The cells of theca interna and granulosa cell undergo hypertrophy and are filled with lipochrome pigment to become lutein cell. This lutein cell contains lipid droplet, abundant smooth endoplasmic reticulum and mitochondria. This is called the corpus luteum. Corpus luteum, if the liberated ovum is fertilized, the corpus luteum will survive for 4 to 5 months under influence of human chorionic gonadotropin, chorionic NIC, here spelling mistake, NIC, chorionic gonadotropin hormone, and is called corpus luteum of pregnancy. If fertilization does not occur, the corpus luteum function for only 10 to 12 days is called corpus luteum of menstruation. If fertilization does not occur, luteum function for only 10 to 12 days activity over undergo infection and with the function. This is for picture shows the formation of the corpus luteum after ovulation, the wall of follicle collapse and form the lutein cell. This is called corpus luteum. There are two fate of corpus luteum. This is called corpus luteum of menstruation if fertilization does not occur. If fertilization occurs, the corpus luteum of pregnancy. Corpus luteum survive in pregnancy 4 to 5 months under the influence of human chorionic gonadotropin, and corpus luteum menstruation it survive 10 to 12 days, then it regress from the corpus albicans, the fibrous tissue. So, we often put it under the ability to take it. এখানে নামগুলো আছে না আচ্ছা তোমরা তোমাদের ক্যামেরা গুলো অন করো তো একটু দেখি জিজ্ঞেস করে দেবে না আমি কত গুলো বিষয় বুঝি from 9 to 17 are you present here
Yes, ma'am.
Tell me the definition of ovulation.